You're listening to the Chapter a Day Audio Bible. I'm John Stonge, and today we're in 2 Timothy chapter 4. And we'll be reading from the Christian Standard Bible. I solemnly charge you before God and Christ Jesus, who is going to judge the living and the dead, and because of his appearing and his kingdom, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Rebuke, correct, and encourage with great patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but according to their own desires will multiply teachers for themselves because they have an itch to hear what they want to hear. They will turn away from hearing the truth and will turn aside to myths. But as for you, exercise self-control in everything. Endure hardship. Do the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time for my departure is close. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. There is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but to all those who have loved his appearing. Make every effort to come to me soon, because Demas has deserted me, since he loved this present world, and has gone to Thessalonica. Crescens has gone to Galatia, Titus to Dalmatia. Only Luke is with me. Bring Mark with you, for he is useful to me in the ministry. I have sent Tychicus to Ephesus. When you come, bring the cloak I left in Troas with Carpus, as well as the scrolls, especially the parchments. Alexander the coppersmith did great harm to me. The Lord will repay him according to his works. Watch out for him yourself, because he strongly opposed our words. At my first offense, no one stood by me, but everyone deserted me. May it not be counted against them. But the Lord stood with me and strengthened me so that I might fully preach the word, and all the Gentiles might hear it. So I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil work and will bring me safely into his heavenly kingdom. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Greet Priscilla and Aquila and the household of Onesiphorus. Erastus has remained at Corinth. I left Trophimus sick at Miletus. Make every effort to come before winter. Eubulus greets you, as do Pudens, Linus, Claudia, and all the brothers and sisters. The Lord be with your spirit. Grace be with you all. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your word, and we thank you for the privilege of being able to read this portion of Scripture today, knowing that it's believed that this was the last portion of Scripture that the Apostle Paul wrote down before he was executed. And Lord, as he took a look at those who worked around him and those who had served with him and those who had deserted him, he was mindful of what was really important in life, and that's knowing you through faith in your Son, Jesus Christ, and making the message of the gospel known in every context that you place us in, not fearing harm, not fearing evil, not continually trying to consume the things of this world or love the things of this world more than we love you, but faithfully using our lives, recognizing that they are stewardships that are meant to be used for your glory, so that others can be helped, so that others can learn the gospel message as it's proclaimed from our mouths and backed up with our lives. And we could see Paul challenging Timothy and others to live this kind of way. And Lord, we pray that we would take this as a personal challenge as well. So thank you for the service of men like the Apostle Paul, who were willing to give their lives for your glory. And we pray, Lord, that we would be inspired by that example as we walk by faith in your Son, Jesus Christ. We commit this day to you, Lord. We're grateful for it, and we're grateful for your love that you show us in so many ways. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks again for listening to the Chapter a Day audio Bible. Each week we post in-depth and applicational Bible studies on our blog at desirejesus.com. This content is always free, and it's our prayer that the Lord would use these resources to strengthen your daily walk with Him. Visit us at desirejesus.com to take a look. Thanks again for listening, and have a wonderful day.